friends, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So in today's biology session, we are going to discuss about the reproduction in plants. Already in our first video, we have discussed about the different modes of the reproduction, that are sexual and asexual. Among that, we were discussing about the asexual mode of the reproduction. In that, we have already discussed about the one method of the asexual reproduction, that is for vegetative propagation. So in today's session, we are going to discuss about some other methods of the asexual reproduction. In that, first we are going to see, or we are going to discuss about the fragmentation. Okay. So what is meant by the fragmentation, and which type of the organisms are showing this fragmentation? So this fragmentation basically is shown by an algae. Now what is meant by the algae? During the rainy season, you can see on the stagnant water or in the lake water, the green color layer or the surface of that lake water or the green stagnant water has become green in the color. So that green color substance that you can see on the stagnant water or on the lake, that is nothing but what? Algae. Okay, also in the image you can see how exactly it is algae. So these algae contains the chlorophyll, that's why it is a green in a color. And these algae can get reproduce, or these algae showing the asexual mode of the reproduction, that is with the help of the fragmentation. So the algae can get reproduced with the help of this fragmentation method. Okay. So see, this is the algae, or we can say that the algae or the pieces of the algae are there. There are the long strips of the algae are there. So when these long strips or the long bands of the algae are get broken mechanically, then they are getting spread into the different parts. Okay, they get breaks into the so many parts, and then each part is started to grow as a separate individual. Okay, see, fragmentation is only about breaking, get breaks down. Okay. So this body of the algae gets broken mechanically, it gets broken into the so many parts or the so many pieces. Then each piece, see here, this is the one algae I have shown here, it gets breaks into the two parts. Okay, so from this one algae we are getting now here two different algae. Okay, so this each part is starting to grow as a separate individual. Again this algae will get reproduced by fragmentation. Again this algae will get break down, again it forms the two more algae, then again it will get break down, and again it forms the two different algae. Then these two algae are starting to live as a separate individual. Okay, so in this way the algae is showing the mode of the reproduction, that is what? Fragmentation. Each piece, the body of the algae get break down mechanically or with the help of the certain reasons, then that each break or broken part is starting to grow as a separate individual. Okay, so this is about what? Fragmentation, breaking down. Fragmentation is what? To break down. So this is the first method of what? Asexual reproduction. Now we will discuss about next one, that is spore formation. Okay, and this spore formation is shown by the fungi. Okay, so which type of the organisms are getting reproduced with the help of the spore formation? That is nothing but what? Fungi. And here we have seen the first example, that is what? Algae. So the algae get reproduced with the help of a fragmentation method. So let's discuss about the spore formation. So this spore formation basically found in the fungi. Now what is meant by the fungi? So you have done in the activity in your 6th standard also, or in the lesson number 1 also. What we have done in that activity? We have taken one bread piece, some water, we have sprinkled some water over it, and that bread piece we have kept into the one airtight container. Then after certain days or after 2 days, when you open that airtight container, you can see the cottony like structure get appears on the piece of the bread. So that cottony like structure appears on the bread, that is nothing but what? Fungi, which we are calling as a mold. Okay, which we are calling as a mold. So in the image also you can see that mold, how it get appears on the bread. So now let's see how these fungi get appears on the bread, or how the fungi is getting reproduced. Okay, so see here, this is the structure of the fungi. Here you can see the rhizomes. Okay, rhizomes like the root like structure, which is called as what? Hypha. Here the one circular ball like structure you can see, that is what? Sporangium. And in that sporangium there are the so many small spores are present. Okay, so in the bread mold, if you observe that fungi properly, here like that circle like structure you can see, and like that thread like structure you can see, that thread like structures are what? Hypha. And this circular structure, it is called as sporangium. And inside that sporangium, there are the so many small spores are present. Okay. So once this sporangium get mature, it get burst, and all the spores are coming out from that, and then all the spores get spread in the air. So we can say that the spores of the fungi are already present in the atmosphere. Okay, the spores of the fungi are already present in the atmosphere or in the air, and these each spores are having the protective layer, or the very hard protective layer, to protect them from the adverse climatic condition. For example, we can say that from the extremely hot climatic condition or from the extremely cold climatic condition. So each spores are having the protective layer which protects the spores from the adverse climatic condition. Next one, when these spores are getting the favorable condition like that air, water and warmth, then these spores started to get germinate, and then it forms the fungi. Okay, then it forms the fungi. So that is the main reason. During the rainy season, you can see that on the different surfaces, like on the hood, if there are the leather clothes, on the wall, we can see this cottony of the white color structure, that is nothing but what? Fungi. Why it grows mostly in the rainy season? Because during the rainy season, the weather is what? Climate, or the humid, or we can say the moisture is more in the air, which is a very good, or which is a favorable condition for the production of the fungi. That is the reason during the rainy season it grows in a more amount. Okay. So it means during the summer season the spores are not present in the air? No, it is not like that. During the summer season also the spores are present in the air, but they are not getting the favorable condition for their germination, so that they doesn't get germinate. And during that adverse climatic condition, their protective layer protects these spores. Okay. So this is the spore formation in fungi. This is the spore formation in fungi. Spores are already present in air, which are present in the sporangium. This sporangium get burst, and then the spores comes out. When it gets favorable condition, then it started to get germinate. Okay. So this is the another mode of the asexual reproduction, that is what? Spore formation. And the fungi get reproduced with the help of the spore formation. Now we will move for the next one type of the asexual reproduction, that is budding, which is shown by the yeast. Okay, which is shown by the yeast. Now what is mean by the yeast? Yeast is a single cell fungi that we are using into the bakery. Okay, in the bakery products. Okay, so how this yeast is getting produced? Okay, so see, this is what yeast cell. Okay, this is what yeast cell, mature yeast cell. Then these mature yeast cells started to form one bulk. Okay, one the projections over it, or one the bulk like projection over it, which is called as what? Bud. Which is called as what? Bud. That bud started to get mature, and when it get mature, it get detached from the yeast cell. Okay, it get detached from the yeast cell. And that each bud started to grow as a leafy, new individual, started to grow as a separate individual. Okay. So what happened in the budding? This is what yeast cell. So that mature yeast cell started to produce what? Bulb-like projection. Okay. Or the projections comes out, or bulb-like projection is comes out, and that projection is called as what? Bud. Okay. So this bud started to mature. And once it get mature, it get detached, it get separate from this mother yeast cell, and this bud started to grow as a separate individual. Sometime what happened? So many buds started to appear over one. Okay, one another one, so many buds. But the chain of the buds started to get appears on the bud, and it get detached from each other, and they started to grow as a separate individual. Okay. And that is the reason this yeast can get reproduced within a very short period of a time, because they are having the ability to form the chain of the buds, which gives the more number of the yeast cell, which helps to reproduce the more number of the cell. Okay, so this is about what? Budding in the yeast cell. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the fragmentation, which is shown by the algae, spore formation, which is shown by the fungi, and the budding, which is shown by the yeast cell. Okay, how is the budding? See here in the image also, you can see how exactly the budding takes place in the yeast. Okay. See, here I want to give you one more example in the fungi. As we know, the fern plant. See, in the image, here is the fern plant. So that fern plants are having the back side of the leaves are having the brown color spot, which we are calling as a sori. And that sori is useful to reproduce the plants. Okay, so in this way, what happens? The spore formations helps to reproduce the fungi. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We'll meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.